Welcome to Office 2013 video number 7. Hey, in this video we want to talk about hyperlinks and save as web page. Now I opened up a blank Word document. It says Doc 1. I'm going to hit the F12 key to save this. Save as dialog box comes up. I'm going to dig down into my system of folders, my drive, Highline, this quarter, 216 class notes, Word. Now, I'm going to eventually save this using save as and the save type here to save as a web page. So when I type a name, I don't want to put any spaces. I typed hyperlink and web page. Now, right now, we're going to save it as .docx. This will just be a regular Word document. Later, we'll do save as and convert it to a web page. All right, so hyperlinks. You've probably seen this before. www.google.com. You type some address, and when you hit enter, it automatically converts to a hyperlink. The same thing happens for email addresses. You can actually go to this hyperlink when you're in Word by doing Control and click, and that'll open up whatever website it is. Now, oftentimes that's annoying, so it's helpful to know how to turn this off. We can go to File, Options, Proofing. Hey, we were here last video. Auto corrections. Hey, we did auto corrections and built our own custom shorthand, but we want auto format as you type. And then you can uncheck that right there. That will not automatically add hyperlinks when you type an email or a web address and hit Enter. I'm going to click Escape, Escape. All right. If you need to edit this, you can right click, Edit Hyperlink. This opens up the hyperlink dialog box. All right, I'm going to click Escape. I'm going to show you how to just start off with the hyperlink dialog box, because there's a lot you can do with that dialog box. The keyboard for hyperlink is Control K, or you can right click hyperlink. There's also up on the insert is without a keyboard. Hyperlink is up there, but the keyboard is Control K. Control K, if you ever use Microsoft web editing software, Control K works there too. Now, here's the cool thing. You can just type an address. So www.jill-boomerang.com. And I hope I spelled it right there. I didn't. I got two E's. I could feel that E. Boomerang.com. So there's the address. And you can not have the web address displayed. You could simply type something different. Run with boomerangs. Now this is just one of the options. Notice you can, it's showing the current folder. You can actually build a hyperlink to a file. So inside a Word document, you could control click a link and it would open up another Word document. You could also go somewhere else in this document. Also in Excel. Excel, you could literally click place in this document and have a hyperlink that jumps to a different sheet. All right, I'm going to click OK, Enter. So now if I control click, I go to the Gel Boomerang website. Now you can put hyperlinks in pictures. So if I go online pictures, all right, I'm going to come down not to Clipart, but to Bing. And I'm going to be very specific. I'm going to say I want a Gel Boomerang. I'm going to say show all web results. And there it is. So these are boomerangs that I designed back when I ran the boomerang manufacturing company, Gel Boomerang. So I'm going to select this one here. Here's the, actually, this is the Deuce. We did a spell check on this boomerang last video. So Deuce, there it is. Now, I wonder if this has a hyperlink. I'm hovering over. If it has a hyperlink, usually you see that. Control and click. Also, you can right click the object. And if it says Edit Hyperlink, you'll see that there's a hyperlink. But there's no hyperlink. I want to put a hyperlink on this. When I save this as a web page, I want to be just like a normal picture. You click on it, and it takes you somewhere else. So I'm going to point to hyperlink, and I'm going to type an address. Notice we can't put anything there because the picture contains the hyperlink. Now, the big problem is you want to be sure and click the actual picture and not next to the picture when you're inserting a hyperlink into that picture. I'm going to click OK. So now when I have my cursor, I can see that screen tip there. When I right-click it, you could see it says Edit Hyperlink. So if I Control and click, it'll open it right up. That was slow. I'm going to close the current all tabs. Another type of hyperlink you might want, let's say this is a report about a company and you have some financial statements. You'd like a link so they can control click. Financial statements, I'm going to highlight this. Control K. Now, I don't have any financial statements. This is just something from our right inside of our folder, right? I'm just going to show you that you can actually link to another file. Here's our flyer finished. That's what we created last video or two videos ago. So I'm going to double click that. And now if I control and click, it'll open up that flyer. So there, you can have hyperlinks inside of Word documents or PowerPoints or Excel files that lead to other files. All right, so hyperlinks. There's lots of fun with hyperlinks. Now, save as web page. Now I want to show you something. Go over to our web page. Here, this is a website I created with Web Expressions. It's Microsoft's website creator. I'm not a great, I don't know how to type HTML and all that kind of stuff. But check this out. Here's a link. I'm going to click on it. That syllabus is a web page, right? You can see the .htm. This is something I just made in Word. Here's the syllabus. All I did was save as web page. So I'm going to click back. Now let's see how to do that. So here's nothing. We have a couple links and a picture, right? All we have to do, I'm going to Control S. So I saved the Word document, the .docx. Now if I F12, all I have to do to convert this to a web page is change the extension. I want to change the extension to webpage.htm.html. That asterisk means it's a wildcard. It means you can have lots of characters before, but that'll be the extension at the end. I don't want this filtered one or this single one. Those are both junk, but this is a web page we can use. Click. So there is the extension. We're using Save As to change the file extension to create a new file from a Word document. You can see that .htm. Our file path, we can see it right. Oh, so there's our file path. It's our folder. So I'm going to click Save. So now this is still in Word. It is still, now it's treating this simple web page. It's using Word as an editor, but I'm going to close this. Go over to Windows Explorer. And notice, what did it do? There's a .htm, but there's also the second folder. It creates two things. If you're going to drag this or copy this and paste it to a server computer that's connected to the internet, you have to copy and paste both of them. And then you make the link connected to that one. And that's how I did this simple web page. All right, I'm going to click back. Now, if you open it from this file, remember, this is just our jump drive, right? It is now a web page, so it'll open not in Word by default, but whatever the default browser is on your computer. So when I double click this, it will open in the default browser. So that's a little web page we made just in Word. If I click Google, it goes to Google. I click back. If I click this picture, it goes to the website. All right, that's just a little teeny bit about hyperlinks and save as web page in Word. We're not going to do it over in Excel, but if you ever have, you know, a cool budget or something and your boss says, hey, I need that just to post on our website, the save as web page in Excel works totally awesome. It doesn't even create two files. It just creates one, and it looks good when you post it on the internet most of the time. All right, we'll see you next video. Next video will be, we'll start chapter 2, and we'll talk about research papers and all the awesome tricks there are in Word for making research papers more fun than they usually are. All right, see you next video.